Hello aviators, how are you today? My name is Magna Nordahl, I am an ATR captain and instructor. And here are some news from Toulouse. According to Flight Global, ATR abandons STOL variant. STOL means short takeoff and landing. ATR has ended its effort to develop a short takeoff and landing STOL variant of the ATR 42-600 after failing to secure as many orders as it had hoped. Well, that's really sad because I have been looking forward to see this aircraft in action. But it's the market who decides whether they need it or not. So this variant was announced in 2019 to replace aging aircraft like the Dash 8-200. So why did ATR not receive more orders for this aircraft? The main reason is the market has changed. Let me explain. ATR was founded in 1981, and a couple of years later, the CEO said in an interview that the intention was to produce a regional airliner, but they did not look into the short takeoff and landing segment because that market was not big enough. So they let DHL in Canada keep that market for themselves. In 1983, DHL in Canada launched the Dash 8-100 model. And it's perfect for short runway operations, and it was followed up by the 200 with more powerful engines and therefore much better performance. The production of this model ended in 2009 because the demand was shrinking. But as these aircraft are getting older, they will soon later become a market for short takeoff and landing aircraft in this category from 30 to 50 seats. So ATR decided, yes, there is a need because there are a lot of airports around the world with short runways, 800 meters and up. So they decided, yes, we can make a short field landing version of the 42-600. And what they did, they operated the engine power because the 600 is using a much more powerful engine, but derated it to 2400 horsepower. Now they made an option so you can increase that power. That requires a bigger rudder, which they have then modified. They also allow you to take off with flap 25, which means less stall speed at takeoff and therefore shorter takeoff distance. They also modify the brakes to be deployed automatically, and two spoilers on top of the wing who deploys together with the ailerons, they will now pop up on landing. All this together made this aircraft capable to operate from such runways. And when they launched this product in 2019, they quickly got 21 orders. But since then, nothing else happened. They did not manage to get more orders. One reason for that is the market has changed. Many places, they increased the runway length, which make it available for normal ATR 42 and also the 72s. I have flown both models on 1200 meter runways, and I can carry pretty good loads. So therefore, a specialized version is in less demand nowadays. It's very sad they had to cancel the project. I will have loved to see it in operation or flight. But if you don't get buyers, you cannot continue. It's sad, but okay. Another thing, you may have noticed that under the video, you will see you can join me as a member on this channel. And while it costs you quite a small amount, from $1 up per month, you help me a lot. because it takes a lot of effort to produce videos. So thank you to all of you who support me. I really appreciate. And as we say in Fiji, Vinaka. And that's all for this time. Have a wonderful day and happy learning.
Thank you.